Wind turbines are very, very complex engineered systems, which is one of the reasons why we want to look at ways to build wind turbine blades that are integrally manufactured, right, where we can make a single part with composite materials, where we don't have to have multiple components, and we can build that material so it's very durable. If you're going to manufacture composites for large manufacturing applications, you need to do a few things. You need to reduce the amount of energy that you put into the composite material to do things like cure it, to harden the material and make it a material you can use. You need to also ensure that there aren't any flaws in the material when you're making it, because one thing you don't want to do after you manufacture it is fix it. During the manufacturing process, we're going to monitor variables like temperature from the surface using infrared imaging, and then based on that measurement, we're going to be able to understand what's happening within the part with the temperature, and using that measurement, control the process to avoid flaws and also reduce the amount of energy that it takes to make that composite wind turbine blade. So this material, this resin, the reason it's important, this thermoplastic, is because it cures itself, and then later on, we can actually melt down that thermoplastic and reclaim the valuable part of the composite, the fiberglass. And then that fiberglass can be reused. It can be reused in a wide array of composite materials, other composite materials for other manufacturing applications. And so we don't need to throw it away. We don't need to put it in a landfill. And so we can make wind energy overall a more sustainable kind of manufacturing process, and we can reclaim the value of that fiberglass material.